Now, since many of you have rushed to his defense, Jazakumullahu khairan, first and foremost, I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bless you all abundantly for having this jealousy and love for your fellow Muslims. It's a wonderful trait that you want to defend the honor of every Muslim out there. Alhamdulillah, that's nothing that is blameworthy. However, sometimes in the process of you defending the honor of a Muslim, you wind up compromising the truth Allah revealed. And no honor of any Muslim is superior to the truth. So while you're excited about defending every speaker that we have spoken about, please take a step back, reflect, educate yourself, and then reassure yourself that you really want to defend someone, because when you defend, we're not concerned about the person, we're concerned about the information the person is conveying. So when you defend a person, you're also indirectly defending their stance, and if their stance contradicts the Quran and the Sunnah, then you have technically gone against the Quran and the Sunnah. And Allah says clearly in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعَ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Whoever opposes the messenger after the truth has become clear to him or her or to them, and they follow a path other than that of the believers, and we will discuss that later inshallah what exactly that means, then we will let them take the path they have chosen, but we will let them go to the hellfire, and what a terrible abode. These are the words of Allah Azza wa Jal, and there are many ayat of the Quran that teach us Muslims not to go against the Quran and the Sunnah, not to oppose Allah and His Messenger. So if someone is going to bring about an understanding that opposes that of the Quran and the Sunnah, you have an obligation towards your religion to abandon this person. And then after abandoning this person, if their opinions remain to be out there, you also have an obligation to warn against them. You have an obligation to protect the other Muslims from their poison. Yes, yes, you have to. Don't get overwhelmed and think, No, you have an obligation. That is what a Muslim does. You are a Muslim because of the Quran and the Sunnah. You are not a Muslim because of me or Imran Hussain or Yasser Qadi or Omar Sulaiman or anybody. You're a Muslim because of the Quran and the Sunnah. And if you're going to choose a personality over the Quran and the Sunnah, then you haven't really submitted to Allah and you don't know Tawheed. You don't know Tawheed. I'm talking to even people that follow me, quote unquote, blindly. And anyone who follows me, and I'm nobody, has already learned from any lecture I've given that we don't have this fanaticism with people, and we don't follow anyone blindly, and you cannot possibly be a fan of mine, quote unquote, and then put me ahead of the Quran and the Sunnah. If I say something that opposes the Quran and Sunnah, then you have to dismiss it. If you advise me that I don't rectify myself, you have to warn against me. Not about my personal life, about my religious views. Otherwise, you're also betraying the deen of Islam, and you're betraying the amana which Allah placed on you. So please understand that we're doing this for a noble reason. You can't grasp it, you can't understand it. I hear you, I feel you, but you need to grow up a little bit. You need to broaden your understanding and need to realize that there's no jealousy, there's no personal beef, none of that. I've made plenty of videos that already dismiss those ideas. This is a matter of standing up for the truth. And the truth that we stand up for is based on the Quran and the Sunnah and the understanding of the righteous predecessors. And that's what gives us that confidence to say, yes, we are upon the truth and that person is not. And no, I'm not the only one who's going to Jannah. Just because we're refuting misguided people doesn't mean we feel secure. Oh, Abu Mus'ab, straight in Firdaus al-A'la. Wallah, wallah, if I make it to Jannah, I will be the most fortunate soul in the world. I hope and pray Allah will accept anything I do and forgive all my sins. We don't have this mentality that we're on the right path in the sense that I am doing so well as a Muslim. No, no, no. I am so confident in the truth that Allah revealed and that Allah did not leave us unattended. Allah did not leave the truth ambiguous. That I'm very confident about. That is what I promote. As for my personal relationship with Allah, I'm a miskeen. And all those who follow me are masakeen. We are all humble slaves of Allah. But we're not humble when it comes to the truth. Because if I'm going to be shy with the truth, then the person with falsehood is going to have bravery. And then I'm giving him an edge. And I'm giving the falsehood a round of entertainment that it's not entitled to. It is not. So then we promote the truth confidently, because I can say to anyone on planet Earth, look dude, my understanding of the Quran is what the Sahaba said. And my understanding of the Sunnah is what the Sahaba said, and those who followed them, and those who followed them. Period. If you're able to match that, barakallah feek. If you're going to follow some Islam based on Maulana Zingi Bingi in Takatuku, Allahu Akbar. Then that's between you and Takatuku and Zigi Zigi. We don't have that stuff. We don't. So of course I'm going to be confident that someone like Imran Hussein is completely lost, like completely out of this world lost. I will prove it to you. But before, let's learn who Imran Hussein is.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.